Hello everyone, welcome to the next video of our CN course, and in this video we are going to discuss about the communication using UDP. So in our previous video we just discussed about the predefined functions which are used to interact between process and the operating system, right? Now how basically the communication is set up using UDP and those predefined functions we will be seeing in this video. So let's start with it. So we discussed in the starting of this chapter that UDP is a connectionless iterative kind of server, right? So here we will be seeing how the communication is set up using UDP. Like we just discussed about these function calls in the previous video, right? Now with the help of these predefined functions, we will be seeing how the communication is being set up between the client and the server, right? So firstly, the server side starts first, right? So here with the socket function call, the socket gets created, and after that the socket is connected with the port with the bind function call, right? And here the local socket address is also filled. After that, with the receive from function call, basically it is a sort of a function which gets, with this call which gets blocked, the server gets blocked till it receives any request from the client, right? And as soon as it gets any request from the client, it gets unblocked and then it handles that request, right? And after handling that request, it sends the service to the client, right? It sends the data to the client, right? So this is all about the server side, and let's look at the client side. At the client side, firstly with the socket call, socket function call, the socket gets created, and after that we have the send to call, and with this send to call the datagram is sent to the server. Like this, with these send to function call, client is sending the request to the server, right? And after sending the request, it calls the receive from function, and with the receive from function, this is like I just told you that this is a blocking kind of function, and as till it gets any reply from the server, it gets blocked, and as soon as it gets the reply from the server, it gets unblocked, right? Like as soon as it gets the service from the server, it gets unblocked, and after the work is done, it calls the close function, and with the close function, the socket which was created earlier, it gets closed, and this is how the communication is set up between the client and server using UDP, right? So now next we will be seeing how the communication is set up using TCP. So see you in the next video. Thank you.